Good evening po mga kapatid. Welcome po once again sa ating pong Tuesday online prayer watch. At marahil po kayo ay may ina-expect sa Panginoon ngayong gabing ito na kumilos siya sa ating kalagitnaan. At ito po ang pananampalataya po natin at patuloy po tayong umasa na tayo po ay kikilusan ng ating Panginoon sa panahon po na ito. At this moment po, tayo po ay magbukas ng ating pong mga Bible sa Colossians chapter 1 verses 27. Ang sinasabi po dito sa Colossians chapter 1 verse 27, God has chosen to make known among the Gentiles the glorious riches of this mystery. Ano po yung mystery na yun? Which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. God has chosen to reveal Himself to us through His Son. And when He was revealed to us, nung ipinakita niya po ang kanyang sarili sa atin po, nung pinakita po ng Diyos ang kanyang sarili sa atin sa pamamagitan po ng kanyang anak, ang kanyang pong banal na espiritu ay nananahan sa atin permanently. Niniwala po ba kayo na ang banal na espiritu ay nananahan na sa ating mga puso? Our hope of glory is our resurrection. Yun po yung pinakaiintay natin, ang pag-asa ng kaluwalhatian ng ating katawan na ito ay babaguhin ng Panginoon, magiging immortal po tayo, kagaya po ng katawan ng ating Panginoong Jesus. Yun po ang sinasabi po dito, hope of glory, na tayo po ay magiging bahagi ng kaluwalhatian po ng Panginoon sa pamamagitan po ng ating Panginoong Jesus sa kanyang pagbabalik po. This hope fuels our hearts to praise God for His amazing grace that He poured upon us. We were once a lost sheep, but we have been found by the great shepherd, and in His hand we are secure, for no one can snatch us away from Him. No matter what our circumstances are right now, they are only temporal, mga kapatid. God gives us the strength to endure by Christ's Spirit who is in us to be able to overcome whatever trials or challenges that we have here sa ating pong buhay na ito. At alam po natin ang banal na Espiritu ang siyang nagli-lead po sa atin, siya po ang nag-guide sa atin, siya po ang nag-encourage sa atin sa pamamagitan ng kanyang salita, ng mga pangako po ng Diyos. At siya rin po ang nagtatransform sa atin so that we will be perfected in the day of Christ when He returns. So ngayong gabing ito po, let's take courage by the fact that His Spirit lives in us, mga kapatid. Therefore, we are strengthened and encouraged that we are not alone in this life, that Christ is with us every moment, every second of the day. At napakasarap pong isipin na ang Panginoon ay kasama po natin at wala pong makakapag-separate sa atin sa kanya pong pagmamahal. Amen? Tayo po ay tumungo sa ating pong pag-awit sa Panginoon. Aming Amang nasa langit, kami po ay nagpapasalamat po sa inyong salita o Diyos na nagpaalala po sa amin na kami po, Panginoon, ay may iniintay na kaluwalhatian, Panginoon, na ibabahagi niyo po sa amin. At ito po ang pag-asa namin, Panginoon, ang inyong pagbabalik at ang aming pong resurrection, Panginoon, ng aming pong mga katawan. At habang kami nag-iintay, Panginoon, sa pagbabalik ninyo, O Diyos, kami po lamang, Panginoon, ay patuloy na aasa, Panginoon, na You will be with us, that whatever our circumstances are in this life, Lord, we know that You are with us. We know, O Lord, that You are the one who will strengthen us. You are the one who will lead us and guide us, Lord. You are the one who's going to sanctify us, O God, Panginoon. And Lord, help us to be trusting in You, Lord. Kami po lamang ipatuloy na magtiwala po sa inyo, that we would humble ourselves before You, O God, knowing that we cannot do anything, Lord, apart from Christ. For indeed, O Lord, we are powerless. We are hopeless, O God, apart from Him. And we thank You, O Lord, for Christ indeed is living in us, and He is the hope of our glory. Salamat po, Panginoon. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
That once was hidden for ages and salvation, the knowledge of eternal love that came to dwell inside of you is Christ in you, the hope of glory, Christ in you, the hope of things to come. Christ in you, the mystery revealed, living in our hearts, the hope of glory, the mystery that once was hidden for ages and generations, the knowledge of eternal love that came to dwell inside of you is Christ in you, the hope of glory, Christ in you, the hope of things to come. Christ in you, the mystery revealed, living in our hearts, the hope of glory. It is Christ in you, the hope of glory, to come. Christ in you, the mystery revealed, living in our hearts, the hope of glory, living in our hearts, the hope of glory. To worship you, my Lord, you have won my heart and I am yours forever and ever. I will love you. You are the only one who died for me, gave your life to set me free. So I lift my voice to you in adoration. On my heart, and I am yours forever and ever. I will love you. You are the only one who died for me, gave your life to set me free. So I lift my voice to you in adoration. My voice to you in adoration. We praise your name, Lord. We adore you, O God. You are the hope of our glory, Christ Jesus our Lord, who's living in us, Lord. We thank you, O God, for the strength. We thank you, O God, for the everlasting peace. We thank you for the everlasting love, O God, that you've given us, Lord. Thank you, O God, for saving our souls, O Lord. And we look ahead, O God, looking forward, O God, to that day when Christ shall return. And we shall see him face to face to behold the beauty of his glory and his majesty. We thank you, O Lord, and we pray, O God, that you will continue to move in our hearts tonight. We submit, O God, ourselves to you, surrendering, O God, our will, our minds. Lord, move freely, O God, in us. All this we pray, Panginoon, may thanksgiving. In Jesus' name, amen.
A blessed Tuesday evening, our dearest brothers and sisters. Welcome po to our online prayer watch. Ngayon pong gabi pong ito. So, saan man po kayo naroroon, mga kapatid, kayo po ay binabati po namin ng pag-ibig po ng ating pong Panginoong Jesus. Tonight po, ang message ng Panginoon para po sa atin ay patungkol po sa banal na spirito. Ang work ng banal na spirito sa pagsisil po sa atin bilang mga believers po ng Panginoon. Ang text po natin ay kukunin po natin sa Ephesians chapter 1 verses 13 and 14. All right? Ito po ay i-take up natin itong dalawang verses po na ito in two meetings. So, until next Thursday, we will look at the sealing of the Holy Spirit. Ang sabi po rito sa Ephesians 1 13 and 14, let me read to you po. And you also were included in Christ when you heard the message of truth, the gospel of your salvation. When you believed, you were marked in Him with a seal, the promised Holy Spirit, who is a deposit guaranteeing our inheritance until the redemption of those who are God's possession to the praise of His glory. All right. Now, as we have been studying, no, dito po sa ating series on the book of Ephesians, paano po ba finorm ng Diyos ang church, okay? At paano po ba tayo pinagkalooban ng Panginoon ng mga tinatawag na every spiritual blessings in the heavenly realms? We have seen that all the three persons of the triune God are involved. Ano po? Because God's church is based on, first of all, the sovereign election of God the Father. Kita po natin yan sa verses 3 to 6. And then we also saw that the church is based on the redemptive work of Christ, verses 7 to 12. And tonight and next Thursday, we will find that the church is also based on the sealing of the Holy Spirit. Okay? So yun po yun, ano? How is the church formed? All the three persons of the Trinity, of the Triune God, are involved, no, in forming the church, in including a person to be a believer in the Church of Jesus Christ. Now, tingnan muna po natin yung verse 13, ano? Meron po kasi magandang point dito na pinakikita po ang passages po na ito. Sabi rito, and you also were included in Christ when you heard the message of truth, the gospel of your salvation. And then it says, when you believed. Alright, when you believed. Mga kapatid, ang tangi lamang pong maaaring makapagpa-Christian sa isang person, ano po, is the gospel. Alright, sabi rito, you also were included in Christ when you heard, okay, the message of truth. The church should only have one battle cry. It should only have one core message, and that is the gospel. Amen? There is no other message, all right? There is no other message, no, na siyang sentro po, no? If we want souls to be added into the kingdom of Jesus Christ, no? If we want souls to be added into the kingdom of Jesus Christ, friends, there is only one message that has the power, okay, to save people from their sins. And that message is the gospel. You know, last night, I had a privilege, no, na makapag-share po sa isang Bible study, all right? At isa po sa mga napag-usapan po namin ay yung patungkol po sa evangelism, no? Paano ba mag-evangelize, no? Alam niyo po, sabi ng Ephesians chapter 2 verse 1, for you were dead in your trespasses and sins, no? A person is spiritually dead, okay? The moment that he was born into this world, no, spiritually, he is dead in his sins, okay? He is dead in his sins. And the only way for a person to become born again, for a person to become spiritually alive, all right, is through the power of the gospel. Which means you can share to this person, no, all sorts of stuff, no, para seemingly ma-attract mo siya sa church, no? So, kunyari, allure mo siya ng mga turong nakaka-motivate, okay? Ng mga teachings, no, ng mga nakaka-motivate matpatungkol sa morality. Pwedeng you can gain a person, no, more membership attendance, no, by teaching motivational messages, no? But that will not make a person born again, okay? Because it's like a dead body or a corpse, okay? Na inooferan mo, for example, ng biogesic, no? Or inooferan mo, for example, ng masarap na ulam, no? So, kahit anong offer mo, when a body is already, no? When a body is actually dead, no? It won't smell, no? It won't have any senses because it's not alive, no? It's dead. So, kahit tabihan mo siya ng maraming buffet na pagkain, hindi niya yon kakainin. What that body needs, no, is to be what, no? It needs to have life, no? So, ganun din po mga kapatid, no? Sa evangelism, no? Sa evangelism, kahit na magturo tayo ng tungkol sa, no, how to become a better businessman, no? How to taste the best coffee in the world and all those things, no? All those things will not cause a person to be born again. It's the gospel. Amen? It's teaching the message of truth. Tell them the truth. Tell them the truth that we are sinners in need of the forgiveness of God. Tell them the truth that Jesus died for their sins. And it is only by accepting, believing Christ Jesus as our Savior and Lord, no? It is only by believing in faith that we can truly be included in Christ, that we can truly be born again, that we can truly become saved, no? So, ito lang po talaga yung message ng church. Wala nang iba pong message ang church. Amen po. Everything else, kahit na po, it is very, very appealing to this world if it will not cause a person to repent of his or her sins and turn to Christ as Savior, as His personal Lord and Savior, then all of those things, kahit na lumaki pa ng lumaki ang isang iglesia, pero kung hindi po ito founded on the gospel, ano po, nakakalungkot sapagkat po pwedeng we have a big attendance, no? Pero ang question ay, ito ba ay mga genuine po na mananampalataya? Because only the power of the gospel, no? Only the power of the gospel has the power to bring salvation to people, no? Yun lang yung may power na buhayin ng isang spiritually dead na tao, okay? Ito lang ang may power. Only the gospel has the power to make a spiritually dead person is spiritually alive, no? No, when a person believes the message of truth, the gospel of your salvation. Now, siguro isa pa po, no, na point. It is also not through a sacrament. It is not through a ceremony, okay, that a person will become a child of God, okay? It's not through a sacrament or a ceremony that a person becomes a believer. It is by believing the message of truth, no? It is by accepting Christ Jesus into your heart, meaning that you are turning your whole life to the Lord, amen? You are turning, surrendering your whole life to the Lord. And you know that it's gonna be costly when you do that, no? It's not just lip service, okay? Na para ka lang kumuha ng insurance policy para sa yung future. Hindi po ganun, ano? When we accept Jesus Christ as our personal Lord and Savior, it means that we are putting our entire allegiance to His Lordship. Amen? So, yun po yun. Now, let's continue. Sabi rito, and you also were included in Christ when you heard the message of truth, the gospel of your salvation. Tapos sabi po dito, when you believed, okay, you were marked in Him with a seal, the promised Holy Spirit, okay? When you believed, you were marked in Him with a seal, the promised Holy Spirit. Allow me to read to you a very relevant explanation of J.C. Ryle pertaining po to our text. Sabi niya, it takes a great deal more than this to make a man a real Christian according to the standard of the Bible. It requires the cooperation of all the three persons of the Blessed Trinity, the election of God the Father, the blood and intercession of God the Son, and the sanctification of God's Spirit must all meet together on the soul that is to be saved. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit must unite to work the work of making any child of Adam a true Christian. So, my dear friends, it is really a supernatural work, the salvation of a person. Amen? Your salvation, you being a follower of Christ, a believer of the Lord Jesus Christ, that is a supernatural work of God the Son, of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Now, it says here, okay, ano yung role ng Holy Spirit? When you believed, you were marked in Him with a seal, alright? You were marked in Him. Tinatakan ka ng isang selyo, alright? Tinatakan ka. You were marked in Him with a seal, and it is the promised Holy Spirit. Now, when does the Holy Spirit begin to indwell a believer, okay? When does the Holy Spirit... The moment that we believe the Lord, all right? The moment that we hear and believe the gospel, okay? The moment that we hear and believe the gospel, when we receive Christ into our hearts, when we take that step of decision, ano, to give our lives to Jesus Christ, at that very moment, the Holy Spirit indwells us. Amen po. Okay, so ano ba yung ibig sabihin ng seal? Alright? Now, during Paul's time, yung seal na yon refers to the official mark of identification that was placed on a letter, contract, or other important document. I'm sure nakita na natin to, ano po, sa mga movies, alright? Nakita na natin to sa mga news, no? Or dun sa mga history, no? The seal usually was made from hot wax, no? So, I'm sure you remember this, no? From historical movies, no? Na yung envelope, for example, meron siyang may bilog na red dun sa flap, okay? Na yung bilog na red na yun is made of wax, no? So, yun yung parang pinaka-seal ng envelope na yun, ano? Tapos sabi po dito, and it was placed on the document and then it is impressed with a signet ring. So, merong impression, okay? Merong nakabaon, ano, na impression or parang meron siyang sort of like a design dun sa mismong hot wax na yon. And this makes the document and whatever is written inside the document official, meaning it has the authority of the person to whom the sign belongs, okay? Now, what is that seal that marked us as belonging to God, no? When you believed, you were marked in Him with a seal, and it is the promised Holy Spirit. It is the promised Holy Spirit because Jesus Christ on His upper room discourse with the disciples on the night that He was going to be betrayed, no? He told the disciples that the Holy Spirit was going to come and indwell them. Naalala niyo po yun, ano, from our John series. Now, we will be looking at that word seal, alright? Ano ba yung biblical meaning nung pag sinabi natin you are sealed by the Holy Spirit, alright? So, parang, okay, I'm sealed by the Holy Spirit. But what exactly does it mean, ano? There are four meanings and we will only look at three this evening. We will look at the last one next Thursday. Ano po iyon? The four meanings, no, biblical meanings of being sealed by the Holy Spirit are security, okay? Authenticity, what else? Ownership and deposit. So let's look at first security, okay? Security. In ancient times, the seal of a king, a prince or a noble means that something is inviolable. Ano ba ibig sabihin ng inviolable? Inviolable means that something cannot be broken. Okay? For example, an inviolable na law, no? So that law cannot be changed, it cannot be broken, it cannot be dishonored, it cannot be changed in any way, no po? So inviolable. So for example, sa Old Testament when Daniel was thrown into the lion's den, King Darius along with his nobles placed their seals on the stone placed over the entrance to the den, okay? So that nothing, sabi sa Bible in Daniel 6:17, so that nothing might be changed in regard to Daniel. So, since nandun yung seal nung king, okay, ni King Darius along with his nobles, ibig sabihin, hindi na po pwedeng baguhin yung fate ni Daniel na siya ay ikinulong kasama po ng mababangis na leon na ito na para siya po ay, no, para po siya ay in a sense, i-execute, no, by being eaten by these ferocious lions, no. So, it can't be changed anymore because the king already placed his seal doon po sa stone that was placed over the entrance of the den. So, ang ibig sabihin, hindi na pwedeng magbago yung sentence kay Daniel. Any person but the king who broke or disturbed that seal would likely have forfeited his life. So if you try or attempt na i-rescue mo si Daniel, no, so that would mean death for you, no, because that is already sealed. Now, another time that it was used, that word seal, no, is in Matthew 27 verse 66. Ginamit ito dun kay sa grave po ng ating Panginoon. And they went and made the grave secure, alright, sabi rito, and along with the guard, they set a seal on the stone, alright? So, when Jesus died, they put the body of Christ, of the Lord Jesus, inside a tomb, okay? Sabi, and to make the grave secure, and along with the guard, they set a seal on the stone. Ano pong ibig sabihin nun? The tomb where Jesus was buried was sealed. Fearing that Jesus' disciples might steal his body and falsely claim his resurrection, the Jewish leaders obtained Pilate's permission to place a seal on the stone and to guard it with soldiers. In other words, hindi yun po pwedeng buksan. Okay? Hindi yun po pwedeng buksan. Kasi merong seal that it cannot be opened. So, that seal talks about what, no? That the tomb was secure, okay? It cannot be opened. Yung den ni Daniel, it was secure. Hindi yun po pwedeng buksan. Ano po? So, dito makikita po natin, yun yung ginawa ng banal na spirito when He indwelt us, no? He made us secure in our salvation because it means that salvation that we now have, no, it cannot in any way be changed anymore. All right, we are secure in our salvation. Let me give you another scripture. Ephesians chapter 4 verse 30. Do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, by whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. Ang ibig sabihin po nito, the Holy Spirit is our seal, which means nothing can ever change our status as saved children of God. Amen po, no? The indwelling Holy Spirit gives us a security that nothing will ever change our status as sons and daughters of God. All right? We are therefore secured in our salvation. Amen. We are secured. Meron tayong nung seal na iyon, ano? Hindi yun, it's inviolable. All right? It can't be broken, it can't be infringed, it can't be dishonored. We are sealed by the Holy Spirit. We are secure in our salvation, and the Holy Spirit is God's seal, all right? He is God's seal. Parang siya yung signet ring na yon na inimpress dun sa hot wax, no? And the Holy Spirit is God's seal for the day of redemption. Nothing can change the eternal security of the believer. Amen po? So let's go now to the second. What is the next biblical meaning of being sealed by the Holy Spirit? It's authentication. Okay, it's authentication. John 6 verse 27. This I'll give you a scripture where that meaning of seal as authentication is used. John 6:27, do not work for the food which perishes, but for the food which endures to eternal life, sabi po ng Panginoong Jesus, which the Son of Man will give to you, for on Him the Father, God, has set His seal. Alright, sabi rito ng Panginoon, for on Him, referring to Christ, the Father, God, has set His seal. Anong ibig sabihin nun? That the Father, God, has set His seal upon Christ. Ang ibig sabihin po nun, God the Father Himself has authenticated the claim of Jesus that he is the Son of God. Okay? The claim of Jesus that he is true heavenly food. No? Ano bang ibig sabihin? Ano bang nangyayari kapag ino-authenticate mo ang isang bagay? When you authenticate something, it is to prove that something is genuine. Something is true. That's what you do when you authenticate, no? Pag pina-authenticate, ibig sabihin it's an original. Hindi siya false, okay? It's original, it is true, it is genuine, it is not false. And that is the same thing that the sealing of the Holy Spirit means when we are indwelt by the Holy Spirit. It means that we have been authenticated, all right? We have been authenticated na tayo ay totoong, all right? Believers, okay? So, mga kapatid, yung flip side noon, kung wala ang banal na spirito sa ating mga puso, okay? Wala ang banal na spirito sa ating puso. So, ibig sabihin, walang authentication, okay? Hindi tayo genuine believer, okay? So, yun po ang malaking tanong. Is the Holy Spirit dwelling in you right now? Okay? Is the Holy Spirit dwelling in you right now? And friends, again, the only way for us to be included in Christ is to believe the message of truth, the gospel of our salvation. Yung po sinasabi ko po kanina sa inyo sa umpisa po nitong prayer watch po natin. Ano po? Are you a genuine believer? The Holy Spirit authenticates it. He indwells in you, which means I know that I am a believer. I know that I'm not false. Alam kong hindi ako nagpapanggap lang. I know that I'm not a false Christian. I'm not a false believer because the Holy Spirit is in me. All right? He authenticates my salvation. Now, let me again quote to you from J.C. Ryle. Sabi niya, "The indwelling of God, the Holy Spirit, is the common mark of all true believers in Christ. It is the shepherd's mark on the flock, distinguishing them from the rest of the world. It is the goldsmith's stamp on the genuine sons of God, which separates them from the dross and mass of false professors." There are so many who are false professors. And the way to authenticate is to see the evidence that the Spirit is at work in their lives. So, ano yung evidence na makikita natin kung talagang ang banal na Spirito ay nasa sa atin na? Unang-una po sa lahat, mga kapatid, alam naman po natin yun eh, di po ba? Kung ang banal na Spirito nasa puso na po natin eh. Bakit po? Kasi meron po ang kakaibang, ano po, unang-una yung puso natin binago po dahil nagkaroon po tayo ng buhay ng Panginoon sa ating puso. We've been changed. Our hearts have been changed. So, meron na tayong fear of God. Meron tayong conviction. We tremble before the Lord, no? Lalong-lalo na po pagdating sa sin, okay? May conviction po tayo na hindi po tayo mag-sin because the Holy Spirit is holy, all right? He is holy. And if we have the Holy Spirit living in us, holiness is the external evidence that we truly have the Holy Spirit. Of course, it doesn't mean that we are perfect already. But definitely our heart, our life, it is being made pure by the Holy Spirit, no? So we are growing Christians. Amen po, no? Hindi to pwedeng nagdedwell ka ng sin ng ilang taon na tapos wala lang. No, paano po 'yon, ano? So of course, no, may kilos ang banal na Espiritu na kung talagang tayo ay sa Panginoon, nandoon po yung tayo ay manunumbalik sa Panginoon, ano? Pero 'yun na nga lang, paano pag hindi naman talaga tayo nanumbalik at all? So it means hindi talaga yung person na 'yon hindi believer, no? So my dear friends, if you are caught in a time right now we're in, you are playing with sin, no? So repent as soon as possible, no? Confess that and renew your love for the Lord, no? Renew your love for the Lord, no? Dahil wag po nating i-quench yung ginagawa ng banal na Espiritu sa ating puso. And that is the evidence na He is really dwelling in us because He is leading us to the path, no, a life that is holy and pleasing unto the Lord, no. So the Holy Spirit can dwell in us, and at the same time, tayo po, no, we are living a life ano po of no, of carnality na wala tayong nafe-feel na conviction sa puso po natin. Okay? Hindi po pwedeng ganun eh. Kasi the Holy Spirit will really, really convict us, no? And of course, kung wala pa rin, ano po, nandun yung discipline ng Lord, no? Ididiscipline tayo ng Lord kung tayo ay kanyang totoong mga anak. So, sabi nga po sa 1 John 3:24, the one who keeps God's commands lives in Him and He in them. And this is how we know that He lives in us. We know it by the Spirit He gives us, no? Ay, we know it by the Spirit He gives us. He gave us. So, we will really keep God's commands, no? It's not overnight, no? But, yun na nga po, we will be growing Christians. And yung last, the last biblical meaning of the sealing of the Holy Spirit is ownership. Okay? Ownership. Ikaw ay pag-aari, no? Katulad nga nung nasabi kanina ni Jay Cyril, no? The shepherd puts a mark, okay? Puts a mark on the sheep na this particular sheep belongs to him, okay? Sinet apart ka na ikaw ay possession o pag-aari ng Diyos. Romans chapter 8 verse 9. Anyone who does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to him. It is the king's own seal on those who are his peculiar people, proving them to be his own property. Okay? So when we are sealed by the Holy Spirit, sino na ang nagmamay-ari po sa atin? Friends, we are now God's property. Amen? We are now God's property. We are God's divine possession and we belong to God forever and ever. Remember, this is again on the grounds of the redemption of Christ that He bought us, He purchased us with His own blood. That is why ano po, the Holy Spirit dwells in us because we have been redeemed by the saving work of the Lord Jesus Christ on the cross. So these are the three things of the on the biblical meaning of the sealing of the Holy Spirit. First, security. Security meaning if you are sealed by the Holy Spirit, nothing changes the security of your salvation. Amen? Nothing changes it. You are secure forever and ever. No? Hindi po pwedeng ngayon, anak ka ng Diyos, tapos bukas anak ka ng Diablo. Hindi po ganun. Ano? Once you are sealed, okay? Once you are sealed by the Holy Spirit, you are eternally secure. Once you are saved, you are forever saved already because you're sealed. Second, authentication. It is a mark of a true believer, okay? You are a genuine believer and not a false one because the Holy Spirit indwells you. And the third is, you are God's property. You belong to Him. Yung pinakapang-apat po, ay titingnan po natin next Thursday. At pati na rin po ang ano po yung implications nito sa ating pong mga buhay. Alright? So, that is our exhortation for tonight. Let's now come before the Lord in prayer at mag-intercede po tayo para sa ating mga kapatiran. Mga kapatid, tayo po ay merong mga prayer concerns ngayon pong gabi. Unang-una, meron po tayong isang nanonood dito po sa ating online prayer watch. Siya po ay friend ng isa po nating kapatiran sa church, ng member po natin sa church. His name is Brother Mike and he is from the Middle East and nagre-request po siya ng prayer para po sa kanyang kidney stones, no? And ipag-pray na rin po natin ang kanyang spiritual walk with the Lord, no? And second, we have birthday celebrants. Sister Mina and Sister Jovel, we would like to greet you a happy birthday. No, happy birthday po sa inyo. And then ipag-pray po natin yung regathering po natin ngayong November 15. Alam niyo po, napakabuti po ng Panginoon, no, dahil hindi lang po natin na meet yung number of attendees, okay? So, ang nakakatuwa po is because we have something like lima po yung first timers natin. So, may mga members po tayo na na magdadala po ng kanilang mga unbeliever na mga kakilala, mga kaibigan, and loved ones. So, isn't God amazing, no? That in the midst of this pandemic, nag-grow talaga po yung word ng Lord, no? Yung work ng Panginoon, ano po, and only because of the message of the gospel. And then, Brother M will lead us in praying for the concerns of the church. So, tayo po ngayon ay malalangin. Let's first begin to praise the Lord. Father, we bless your name. Father, we worship you. We exalt your holy name, Lord God. Hallelujah. Magpuri lamang tayo sa Panginoon pagkat siya po ay tunay na karapat-dapat. Sinasamba po namin kayo, O Jesus. Dinadakila po namin ang inyo pong banal na pangalan. O glory, glory to your name, Lord. Hallelujah. We magnify your name. You alone deserve all glory and praises, Father God. You are, O Lord, O God, the one and only true God. You are, O Lord, the one who is infinitely glorious, Lord. You are infinitely holy. You are infinitely righteous, O Lord God. Lord, you are omnipotent, O Lord, all-powerful, O God, and all things exist, Father, because of your will. All things exist, O Lord God, Father in heaven, because you are the giver and the source of life. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Kayo po, Panginoon, ang tagapagbigay, Panginoon, ng buhay sa lahat sa daigdig na ito. You are the maker of the heavens and the earth, O Lord, O God. Kami po, Panginoon, O Lord, we are the clay, Lord God. Father, but you are the potter, Lord. You gave us life. You breathe life into us, O Lord. Hallelujah. We exalt you, Lord. We bless your name, O God. Salamat po, Panginoon, ang lahat po ng bagay ay mula sa inyo, O Jesus. O Lord, every good and perfect gift comes from God. Salamat po, Panginoon. And Father, we thank you, Father in heaven, for your word to us, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord God, for the teaching, the doctrine that we've heard, Lord, tonight on the sealing of the Holy Spirit. Father God, it gives us great assurance and peace, O Lord, that we are secure in our salvation, O Lord, because we have been sealed. We have been divinely sealed by the Holy Spirit who indwells us. We thank you, Father in heaven, that we are genuine believers, Lord, Father, because you authenticate our salvation through the Spirit. Marami pong salamat that we are indeed your property. We belong to you, Lord. You are our owner, Panginoon. Salamat po. Father God, sa oras po na ito, nais po naming idulog ang isa po sa aming pong mga viewers. Lord God, we pray, Lord God, for the friend of Sister KJ. Lord, we pray for Mike, O Lord God. Father in heaven, kayo po ang tunay na nakakakilala, Lord, kung ano po ang kanya pong tunay, Panginoon, na situation ngayon, O Lord God. And Father, we commit this person to you. We ask, Father in heaven, that you continue to work in his heart, that you continue to reveal to him, Lord, who you are. You continue to reveal to him, Lord, your love, your gospel, Lord. We pray you will reveal to him, Lord God, how much you love him, your mercy, Lord God, Panginoon, O Lord, Father, your presence, O Lord, that even though he is in a faraway land, O Lord, hindi po siya nag-iisa, Panginoon, pagkat kapiling po niya, Panginoon, ang presence po ninyo. And Father, we pray, Lord God, for his salvation. We pray, Father God, that you will indeed, Lord, call forth this person, O Lord God, to a relationship with Christ. You will call him forth, O God, Father in heaven, to, Lord, to truly come and surrender his whole life, Lord, to your Lord, to your Lordship, Panginoon, and Lord, receive Christ into his heart as his Savior, O Lord. Believe in what Christ has done for him, Lord, and believe Jesus to be his Savior. Salamat po, Panginoon. We commit him to you, Lord, maging ang kanyang health. Dalangin po, Lord, na hindi po siya, Panginoon, magambala, Panginoon, sa kanyang puso, Lord, ng anuman pong physical, Lord God, na ailments na meron siya. Dinadalangin, Lord, na bigyan niyo po siya ng peace, that everything is going to be fine, O Lord God. And we pray, Lord God, na dalhin niyo po siya sa tamang, Lord, mga doctors, Lord God, sa tama pong, Lord, medical procedures if needed, Lord God, upang siya po'y gumaling, Panginoon. And Lord, we know, Father God, na Lord, these are just but instruments, but ultimately, you are our healer, Lord. You are our divine healer. And we pray, Father God, na siya po, Panginoon, ay pagalingin po ninyo mula po sa kanya pong mga karamdaman, specifically, Lord, sa kanyang kidney stones. Salamat, Panginoon, O God. Bless this person, O Lord, Father in heaven. Bless him, Lord God, with spiritual blessings, Lord God, providing him, Lord, with security in Christ. Panginoon, in-offer din po namin sa inyo ang aming pong mga kapatid na nagdiriwang ng kanilang mga kaarawan. We thank you, Lord, for the life of Sister Mina, Father God. Lord, we thank you na nakilala namin siya, dinala niyo po siya sa Gospel of Grace, Lord. Napakabuti niyo po at napakatapat niyo po sa kanyang lakbayin, Lord God. Father God, we've seen, Lord, how you have been so faithful, O Lord, not just to her, but to her entire family, Father God. Lord, we are just in awe of your ways, and we pray for Sister Mina, Lord, that she will truly become a woman of God. Set her apart, dear Lord, from the influences, Lord God, of ungodly friends, from the influences, Lord God, of this world. We pray, Father in heaven, that you will, O Lord, keep her pure, dear Lord. And most of all, we pray that her heart, O Lord, will yearn for a deeper relationship, Lord God, a deeper knowledge of Christ. We pray, dear Father God, na lalo niya pa pong makita, Panginoon, na kayo lamang, Panginoon, ang tunay niyang kasapatan, Panginoon, sa buhay po na ito. May you be, Lord God, her true security, Lord, sa kanya pong anak. Kayo lamang po, Lord, ang magbigay sa kanya, O God, ng assurance at security, Lord, sa buhay na ito na wala pong iba, Panginoon, kundi si Christ po lamang ang kanyang tunay po na foundation. Salamat po, Panginoon. We pray, Lord, also for one of our youth. We pray for Jovel, O Lord God. Salamat, Panginoon, sa buhay po ng kabataang ito. We commit her, Lord, to you that she indeed will continue, Lord God, to grow in the grace and knowledge of Christ. Father God, we pray that even now you will set her apart, Lord God. Father God, for your work, you will set her apart, O Lord God, to serve you. You will set her apart, O Lord, to be a person, O Lord God, Panginoon, who will dedicate, O Lord, her life, O God, Panginoon, O Lord, to living for your glory, O God, and to serving you, Panginoon. Salamat po. Ano man ang kanyang magiging path, Panginoon, dalangin po namin na ang buhay na ito ay hindi po, Panginoon, hindi po ito, Panginoon, mawi-waste. Instead, O Lord God, you will use her life to the fullest, O Lord God, so that you may be glorified, Lord, sa buhay po niya. We pray for her studies, Father God. We pray for her family. We pray, dear Lord, for her needs, that truly, Lord God, you will be the provider, Panginoon, of Sister Jovel. Salamat, Panginoon, sa aming pong kapatid po na ito, O God. We thank you for her life, dear Father. And Lord, we take this time to pray for our regathering on November 15. Thank you so much, Lord, for, Panginoon, for filling our slots. We continue to pray for your protection upon all of us, Lord, and that we might truly gather, Lord, Father God, in the Spirit, Lord, with the full blessing coming from you, O God. We pray for the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, Lord, on November 15, that every portion of the program, maging sa pagdating pa lang po namin, Panginoon, ay punuin nyo na ang aming puso ng kagalakan mula sa inyong spirito. Salamat, Panginoon, sa lahat ng mga kapatiran po namin, Panginoon, na nagpa-enlist, O Lord God, na nag-register, Father God, and alam po namin, hindi nyo bibiguin, Panginoon, ang desire namin ng corporate worship para po sa Sunday po na ito. And Lord, dalangin namin yung pong mga first-timers, Father God. Lord, we pray na nothing will hinder them from attending, O God, on Sunday. And we just pray, kumilos po kayo, Panginoon. O Holy Spirit, we pray for your special work, your special move in their hearts, O Lord, this coming Sunday. Panginoon, O God, tanggalin niyo po ang mga balakid sa kanila pong mga mata, ang kanilang kabulagan, Panginoon. Dalangin namin, O God, na Lord, sila ay kilusan ninyo sa kanilang mga puso, Panginoon, na tunay na sila po ay magsuko ng kanilang buong puso sa inyo. Salamat po, Panginoon. We thank you, Father God. At this time, let's pray for the other prayer concerns.
Dalawang bagay po yung pagpapray natin at this moment. Let's continue to pray for God's wisdom upon the churches in seizing the opportunity to minister to distressed souls during this pandemic. And yung last po ay God's enabling to do His work in the midst of this pandemic and God's gracious favor to anoint His work for the furtherance of His kingdom and glory. Pray po natin yung first. Maraming salamat po, Panginoong Diyos. Lord, na itinalaga nyo maging ang pandemic na ito, Panginoon, upang inyong gamitin, Panginoong Diyos, upang maging golden opportunity po ito, Panginoon, upang, Lord, maraming tao, O Diyos, na nadidistress, Lord, ay maghanap ng sagot, Panginoon, sa kanilang mga buhay. At ang kasagutan po ay wala na po iba kundi kayo lamang, Panginoon. At dinadalangin po namin, Panginoon, that you will continue to bless, Lord, Panginoon, the ministries of your churches, O God, all over the world, Panginoon, that, Lord, your gospel will indeed be told, O God, your gospel will indeed be shared, O God, to this host of people, O Lord, Panginoon, so that they will be saved, Lord. We pray, O God, Panginoon, for the zeal, Panginoon, of each ministry, Panginoon, who are reaching out to these people, O Lord, na patuloy niyo po lamang, Panginoon, gamitin ang lahat ng ito, O Diyos. Equipin niyo po ang bawat misyonaryo, Panginoon. Equipin niyo po ang bawat pastor, ang mga evangelists, even ang mga members, Panginoon, upang gamitin niyo po sila, Panginoon, sa pag-aabot, Panginoong Diyos, sa mga taong, Panginoon, may distress ngayon, Panginoong Diyos. At ito, na, maging ito na po ang panahon upang ang araw, Panginoon, upang sila po ay maligtas, Panginoon. Dalangin po namin na ang iyong banal na Espiritu ang siyang patuloy lamang nakikilos sa pagbabahagi na inyong mensahe, Panginoon. Maging personal man ito o online man, Panginoong Diyos. We pray, O God, Panginoon, that you will indeed bless, O God, your word, O God, and may your Spirit be mighty to move, O God, in the lives and the hearts of, O Lord, of this people, O Lord. We pray, O God, for your enabling, O God, for your churches, Lord, na kayo po, Panginoon, ang patuloy lamang, Ama, na magbibigay ng karunungan, Panginoon, sa amin, ng wisdom, Panginoon, kung paano po effectively, O God, maibabahagi inyong salita, Panginoon, sa mga hindi pa po mananampalataya, Panginoon. Let there be harvest of souls, O God, Panginoon, at this moment, O Lord, at naniniwala po kami na itong pandemic na ito ay magtatagal pa, Panginoong Diyos, at mas marami pa, Panginoon, mga Panginoon, mga hindi pa pumana ng palataya, mga hindi pa po na naliligtas, Panginoon, ang magkakaroon ng salvation, Panginoon. Salamat po, O Diyos. And let's continue to pray for our church that during this pandemic, the Lord will indeed grant us His gracious favor, the anointing that He can give sa ating pong ministeryo po for the furtherance of His kingdom and glory. Salamat po, Panginoon. Father, we pray, O God, for your continuous anointing upon your ministry, O God, in gospel of grace. We pray, O God, for your hand to be upon us. We pray, O God, for your servant, Panginoon, Sister Anne, for your hand, O God, to be upon her. Sa kanya pong pagbabahagi ng inyong salita, Panginoong Diyos, ay patuloy nga lamang na i-anoint you po, Panginoon, ang iyong gawain, Panginoon, sa aming pong iglesia, Lord. We pray, O God, for your people that we will continue, O Lord, to share, O God, Panginoon, your ministry online so that more people, O Lord, will be able to witness, Lord, and hear, O God, your message. We pray, O God, for your anointing upon your ministry, Lord, and we ask, O God, that you will use this indeed, O God, for the furtherance, O God, of your kingdom, Panginoon, in here in our city, maging sa mga taong nakikinig pa po sa ibang mga lugar, maging mga taong nasa abroad, Panginoon, na nagiging bahagi ng ministeryo po na ito namin, Panginoon. We pray that you will indeed, O God, spread, O God, your message, Lord, that your ministry, O God, here in Gospel of Grace, will you will use, O God, in reaching out not just here in our country, Panginoon, to the people in our country, Panginoon, but beyond it, Lord. Truly, Panginoon, kayo po ay faithful, kayo po ay gracious, Lord. And Lord, Panginoon, you can move, O God, beyond what we could ever ask or even imagine. And we thank you, O God, for the opportunity to be used by you, O God, Panginoon. We are just your servants, Lord. And we pray, O God, that you will continue to move in our hearts, Panginoon, upang kami po ay magamit ninyo, Panginoon. Sanctify your people, O God. Grant us, O Lord, Panginoon, the real purpose, Panginoong Diyos, na ma-realize po namin ito. At ito po, Panginoon, ay hindi, walang iba kundi ang kayo ay pagsilbihan. At gamitin niyo ang aming mga buhay, Panginoon, in being able, O God, to reach out to others. We pray, O God, for your kingdom to come, O God, Panginoon. And we pray, O God, that our hearts will be kingdom-centered, Panginoong Diyos. Tutulungan niyo po kami, Panginoon, will be Christ-centered, O God. At upang kami po lamang, Panginoon, ipatuloy ninyong gamitin, Panginoong Diyos, in whatever little ways, O God, that you can, Panginoon. Whether it be by inviting, O God, by sharing, Lord, the link, O God, to our ministry. Kayo po, Panginoon, nakakaalam po ng mga ito, Panginoon. At nalalaman po namin na lumalago, Panginoon, ang inyong gawain, Panginoon, sa inyong kaharian, sa pamamagitan po, Panginoon, ng ministeryo po namin ito, Panginoon, na pinagkatiwala niya po sa amin. Maraming salamat po, Panginoon, for indeed, O God, we know that you are moving, Panginoon, beyond what we can perceive, Lord, Panginoon, sapagkat kayo lamang, Panginoon, ang may kapangyarihan na umabot sa bawat isa, Panginoon, na nakikinig po, Panginoon, ang ministeryo niyo po. Salamat po, Panginoon. We thank you, O God, for tonight, Lord. We thank you for granting us, Lord, once again to worship you, to hear your word, and to pray, O God, for one another and even for your kingdom. And we ask, O God, that you will continue to move in our hearts and allow us, Lord, to grow in Christ. Allow us, O Lord, to see, Panginoon, the blessedness of being a Christian, Panginoon, for we have been sealed by your Holy Spirit, O God, and no one can snatch us away from your hands, O Lord. And we are looking forward, O God, to the hope of our glory, Panginoon, because Christ is living in us, Lord. Maraming salamat po, Panginoon. All glory and praises be unto you and to you alone. All this we pray, Panginoon, in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Maraming salamat po sa pag-join niyo po ngayong gabing ito at pagpalain po nawa tayo ng ating Panginoon.